Hey everybody, welcome to part 2 for Devorah Punishment for Scorpion. As always, you should be able to extrapolate this for your character, but this is primarily going to focus on Scorpion. What I'm going to focus on in part 2 of this is her string cancels into her puddles. Now, she has this in the Swarm Queen variation, so the puddles look like this. So, these are basically the options that you're going to have when she does a string into these puddles. So what I've got here is just going to be a list of all the strings that she can cancel into her puddles and what you can actually do to interrupt them. Now, if anyone doesn't know, the puddles are done by doing down back one with Devorah. So, and what you want to pay attention to here is that the block advantage on these is really, really significant. So if she does something like this, and then you block that low puddle, she can do anything she wants after that. You know, she can do another overhead, she can go for a throw, she can go for... I mean, her lows aren't great. What are her lows again? I think she has back one, maybe? Yeah, back one, that's right. You know, back one and something like this, and if you hit a button, you know, that's going to hit you. So you really do need to... If for whatever reason you end up blocking a puddle, you really need to respect the advantage she gets after a puddle. However, what you may notice is that the puddles themselves have very, very slow startup. You look at that, it's 47 frames. Whether or not that's entirely accurate, I don't really know. But I'm just going to go over the primary strings which these can be cancelled into. If you want to go, as I said, if you want to go over the other strings, go to part one, much like I did in the other videos, to check those, because I'm not going to really cover those strings in this video. This is strictly going to be the punishment for the strings cancelled into the puddles. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go through her regular strings in the order that I can. So we have these ones right here. We've got 1-1, 1-1-2, forward 1-1, forward 1-1-2. You've got 2-1-2, 2-1. So how many is that? Okay, that's the first six. You can only tag six at a time. So I'm just going to leave those on screen briefly and quickly go over the actual punishes that we're going to use. So in my Sub-Zero video for run cancelling standing one out of block, we're going to be using that in this one, but we're not going to be using 1-1, and I'll get to that in a minute. What we're going to be using here is run cancel forward 3. So when you block, you want to buffer in your run cancel and then do forward 3. Like that. So as you can see, that gives a lot more horizontal range to forward 3. And the reason we want to do that is because even though forward 3 does have a nice little hop to it, the horizontal hitbox of the puddles is actually quite big. So even though you might think that forward 3 would be able to get you out of the range, if you do forward 3, the puddle's actually still going to hit you. So this is why you want to use run cancel forward 3, and I'll go over those when I do the strings. The other option, this is the easiest option, and it is really, really nice because it's completely risk-free and it works on every single option. It's just his takedown. So, you know, if you don't want to take the risk for going for something like this, or the other option, which I'll get to, you can just do takedown. It's only 11%, but, you know, it's... You know, 11% is 11%. It's better than nothing. It's better than ending up at minus 20 right next to her, so bear that in mind. The other option, and the hardest option, is going to be instant jump 3 into teleport. Now, instant jump kicks in this game are quite a bit more difficult, in my opinion, than they were in MK9, but basically what you want to do is you want to try and buffer in your initial jump forward out of your block animation. So if I just, I'll just have Devorah do a string right here to show what I'm talking about. She does forward 2-2 like this, and then she holds block. When you actually block that second move, that's when you want to start holding up forward on your pad. So if you look at the left-hand side command list, I'm going to do it here. When the second hit hits me, I'm going to hold it. I missed it there. Missed it again. I might not actually work on these. Yeah, I might have to actually have to do a puddle here. There we go. There we go, yeah. Because she kind of alters her hitbox when she does the puddle. Instant jump 3 actually hits, whereas on a standing opponent it whiffs. So that's what you want to do to use that. That is the harder option, but that's going to get you by far the biggest reward, because even with something like forward 3 spear, you're going to be able to get a pretty nice combo out of this. But if you do a jump kick, you know, you're going to be able to get a really, really nice amount of damage out of doing this. Even, you know, this is Inferno, I mean, this is 30%. That's a very nice chunk of damage. So, without further ado, let's get into the strings. So, as I said, we've got them all tagged up top. So, we've got 1-1, and then puddle. So, as I said, if you do this, if you let her just do 1-1 and then block this puddle, right now she's at plus 20 right next to you, so you don't want to do that. So what you want to do is, as soon as you see the puddle activate, this is what I'm basing this off, because if you do this on a read, then you can actually use EX teleport. but you have to be kind of, you know, right to the point with that. Whereas what I'm trying to do here is wait until I really kind of can visually confirm that she is doing the puddle. So when her arms go to the floor and the bugs come out of her hands, that's when I'm kind of putting in my move so I can visually confirm I have enough time. So for 1-1, your primary options are takedown, like this, and instant jump 3. Like that. So, the one thing, unfortunately, run cancel forward 3 doesn't... Oh, that might be it, actually. Let me try that again. Because in my testing, this didn't work. It looks like it's working. Depends on range from the look of it. It was forward 3 that didn't work. Run cancel forward 3 does actually work, but it is range dependent. If she does it at kind of like the furthest range, then, you know, she is going to be kind of further away, so bear that in mind. But to be honest, if you can do instant jump 3 to punish these, then that really is the move you want to be using, because it gives you by far the biggest reward. It's very, very fast. It's just a little bit trickier to do than the other options. The other one is going to be her 1-1-2. That's this one right here, and you can actually use any of the three options for this one. Oops. You can use takedown, instant jump 3, or run cancel forward 3. Like that. Or you can use instant jump 3. Like that. Whoops. Okay, moving on. We've got forward 1-1. That's this one right here. It would help if I actually did the puddle. We've got forward 1-1 into puddle, like that. And for that one, you can use takedown or instant jump 3. Man, that comes out fast. Like so. This one's actually got a little bit more recovery, so if you don't want to commit to the instant, you can actually do a crossover jump 3. That move's actually worse on block, so you have more time to do that. So that makes that one a little bit easier. The other one is forward 1-1-2 into puddle, like so, leaves you at pretty good distance. For this one, for this one, you can use takedown or instant jump 3. Because of that little gap, run cancel forward 3 is a little bit trickier because, you know, the puddle can still hit you. So I prefer, you know, takedown or instant jump 3 over those. The next one's going to be a 2-1-2, like this one. Bear in mind with this one that the last hit is actually an overhead. Generally speaking, you want to block low against block high against Devorah anyway, as her low options are far less effective than her overheads, which are, you know, really, really good. So she's got 2-1-2. For this one as well, you can use any option at all. It's quite nice spacing after it, so if you want to use run cancel forward 3, like that. Did she just block that? There we go. Run cancel forward 3, or you can use instant jump 3, like so. Next string is going to be 2-1. This one right here. This one's just high mid, so you don't need to worry about that overhead. Much like for this one as well, you can use any option you want. You can either use takedown. Oops. Run cancel, if I can get it right. Come on, Joe. There we go. Oh, I didn't get my spear. You get the point. I'm going to try and keep these videos short, do it on everyone. Or you can use instant jump 3 for that one. Next one's going to be back 2-1. It's this one right here. This one's got quite a bit of startup on the back too, but for this one, you can use any option. You can either use takedown, run cancel forward 3, or instant jump 3. I'm just going to go through the rest now, because I don't want this video to be too long. The next one's going to be forward 2-2. That's overhead mid. That forward 2-2 is kind of, you know, Devorah's bread and butter, so, you know, you really want to be, you know, blocking high to block that. For this one, again, you can either use takedown, instant jump 3, or run cancel forward 3. Entirely up to you. This kind of boils down to whichever you prefer is easier. Run cancel forward 3 and instant jump 3 are going to give you the biggest rewards. However, takedown is, you know, significantly easier. You know, it's hard to just mess up back forward 4. If you want to do a little bit more damage, you could always do EX back forward 4. And if you want to just be classy, you can just X-ray. But that's all 3 meters, you know. I don't really recommend doing that if it's going to close out a round. And the last one is you've got forward 4-4, which is the double mid-kick she's got. For this one, you can use takedown or instant jump 3. Because of the distance she recovers at, you can't actually do run cancel forward 3. The puddle still catches you. So make sure that you kind of have your jump buffered in like that. And then you'll get a punisher. And I believe that does it for this, guys. That pretty much covers all of the strings that she can cancel into the swarm puddles and what you can do. Basically, the biggest takeaway for this is that every single option is actually punishable. So if you see her do this, And you don't, you know, if you don't want to do run cancels or you don't want to do the instant jumps, just play it super safe and do takedown. Because if you keep doing this, then not only does it look super cool, but if you keep doing this, it's going to make the Devorah player hesitant to actually do puddles off of strings. So, you know, and then that's where you can kind of go and check part one and actually look at her strings that are punishable. Because the real kind of, what makes Devorah good in a lot of ways is when you actually block those puddles, because if you're constantly interrupting them and she's never getting that massive frame advantage, then, you know, you're taking away kind of a big part of what makes her good, really. So, you know, that's definitely something to bear in mind. So, I hope this helps you guys, and I'll see you in the next video for whichever one I do. Just a real quick note as well, bear in mind that the EX version of the puddles actually has a little bit wider horizontal hitbox, and it also has a bigger vertical one. So, if you look here, this... Oops. There you go. So, that can catch you out of the air. So, with the EX ones, you need to be very, very, very quick with your punish. So, if you, again, you can play it safe and use takedown. You will actually get a trade on certain distances. The trade is actually in your favor, because these only, the actual puddles only do 5%, as you can see here, whereas your takedown's 11%. So, it's not a bad trade for you, really. Right. There we go. So yeah, that's something to bear in mind if she does the EX. Again, if you do see EX though, you can just play it super safe and just jump forward and jump out. Some of the strings, which I mentioned, have the crossover attempt. You can also use crossover jump 3 for those as well. So, hope it helps you guys fighting Devorah. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.